Clutter be gone. Declutter and simplify your home and keep it that way, starting today. Written by Kimberly Wilson. Narrated by Zehra Fazal. Introduction. America seems awash in clutter. Maybe it's a byproduct of our fast-paced lifestyle and still, despite the recent economic downturn, materialistic society. We have professional declutter services and popular television shows about the most extreme form of clutter, such as hoarders on A&E. It's something that every household grapples with because it's more than a little lack of organization or a little procrastination. It's a real problem. When we allow our homes to become cluttered, they are no longer a peaceful sanctuary where we can escape the stresses of our jobs and the rest of the world. They aren't pleasant for us to live in or for our friends to visit. They make our home lives complicated and stressful. Are you tired of losing your car keys, reading glasses, remote control, and temper in all the clutter? Does the thought that, I really need to take care of that mess, drag you down every day and hold you back from enjoying your time at home? Would you like to get ready for work or school each morning quickly, confident that you can find whatever you need when you need it? If so, you are ready to learn the tricks that will help you turn every room in your home into an organized, tranquil place to be. Declutter experts claim that you will not only improve your quality of life, you can save up to 3 hours a day just by being more organized. What's more, you'll pick up some always welcome cash when you sell your unused items on Craigslist or at a yard sale. More peace of mind, less stress, more time and money. If that sounds like a good deal to you, read on. Why be clutter-free? As you'll learn in the following chapter, getting your life to a clutter-free state will provide an abundance of benefits. You will save yourself time and money, help local charities, and make the world a more sustainable place. Won't you sleep better at night when you check those accomplishments off your to-do list? What is clutter? According to dictionary.com, clutter can either be a verb or a noun, and each form can have several meanings. None of them are good. You aren't going to look at any of the clutter definitions on that site and say, "Boy, howdy, I could use more of that in my life." For our purposes, we'll stick with a couple of the basic definitions. A disorderly heap or assemblage, litter. A state or condition of confusion. I'd like to take it a step further and add this refinement. Clutter isn't just possessions that you leave lying around in a disorderly fashion. If you have possessions that you have tidily tucked away in neatly stacking storage bins, but that you rarely look at and never benefit from, that's clutter too. Everything you own owns you back. And if you don't have a really good reason to keep something, it's just wasting space in your home and chipping away at your peace of mind. Let's be clear. This book isn't going to be about organizing your clutter. It's about being free of it. It's about changing the way you think about your possessions, time, and energy. It's about getting rid of things and habits that are holding you back so that you can move ahead to live a simpler, happier, and more productive life. So let's add a definition to those above. Unused possessions that provide no fulfillment. What? 3 more hours a day? Some declutter professionals, and there are plenty of them around, maintain that you can save yourself 3 hours a day by decluttering your life. That's because you have less junk to take care of, are less likely to lose things, and can maintain a more organized life. Each and every possession that you have needs some kind of care. Even if it isn't an ornate silver tea set that requires careful polishing, it probably needs to be cleaned from time to time, maintained, or at the very least, stored. So the more things you own, the more mental and physical energy gets sapped by them. That's why it's important to take time to consider what you own and in what form you want to own it. How many times have you lost half or more of your Saturday running errands? Your errands are probably based mostly on what you own. Your precious weekend time gets taken up buying cleaners or organizers for your possessions or bringing more possessions into your home. When you turn that mentality around, you will be rewarded with a great sense of freedom. You will spend far less time taking care of and dusting things that don't bring you pleasure. Another time saver is that without the clutter, you are far more likely to find those everyday necessities of life. You know that losing your car keys amongst clutter can easily consume an hour of your valuable time, and always when you can least afford to be late. Clutter leads to lack of organization, which leads to wasted time. It's stressful, too. Being clutter-free means that you have a place for everything and whatever you need comes easily to hand. Imagine how much time it would save if you could readily find the kids' permission slips and backpacks and your laptop charger and cell phone when you need to go out the door in the morning. Financial benefits. Changing your mentality to cut clutter and stay clutter-free provides financial benefits. For starters, getting clutter-free means that you'll be getting rid of things, lots of things. Some of your clutter will be items that you no longer need, outgrown clothes, the duplicate fondue set you received as a gift, etc., things that other households could use. You can make some money selling those items on Craigslist or at a garage sale. If you don't want to spend time selling your possessions, you can donate them to your favorite local charity thrift store. You'll benefit the charity and get a tax deduction for your generosity. Staying clutter-free also means that you'll be more mindful of what you bring into your home, as you will almost certainly make fewer purchases. Some people find that remaining clutter-free significantly changes their shopping habits. You can't very well maintain actively shopping as your favorite hobby and stay clutter-free. You need to limit yourself to window shopping, which will save you time, or cut out pleasure shopping altogether, which saves money and time. When you cut down on unnecessary possessions, the kind you trip over daily and the kind that are tidily stored, you might find yourself able to move to a smaller, less expensive home or rental. Your smaller home will be less expensive in every way, both to pay mortgage or rent on, and to heat, cool, maintain, etc. Some people look at houses without a basement the way some people look at crimes against humanity. They don't understand how on earth such home purchasers store their junk. The square footage in basements, closets, and any other storage area doesn't come free. But do you really want to spend more money housing things you don't need than you spend on housing your family or yourself? Lower stress. You know that clutter is a visual distraction that induces stress. If you scold yourself for letting your mail stack up every time you walk past the hall table, that's stressful. If you constantly rummage through rarely worn clothes in your closet to find your outfit for the day, that's stressful. If you can't find your car keys when your wife's labor pains hit 2 minutes apart. It used to be that one of my most regular stress fests involved having guests at my home. It was bad enough when I invited friends over. That meant hours of dealing with the clutter that I'd been meaning to take care of and hadn't, in addition to cooking and entertaining. Worse, far worse, was when unexpected guests stopped in. I felt that all the petty details of my life were on full display. Well, that's because they were. From the empty ice cream container in front of the TV to the stack of clean but jumbled laundry, my life was on display in a way that I did not want it to be. It's a pleasure now to have a home that is always reasonably presentable. I'm a long way from perfect, but I can tell you that a little consistent effort will be rewarded by a huge gain in stress reduction.
Where do I start? We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.